Hello students, welcome to Knowledge Flow. Today I am once again going to teach you some written communication composition. As we all know, in the world of this multimedia, people prefer to communicate with faxes, mobile phones, emails, etc. Yet the importance of letters is not undermined. So today we will learn letter writing skills. Basically, letter is of two types: informal letters and formal letters. Informal letters are the letters when we write letters to our friends and family, okay? And formal letters are those letters when we write a letter to any authority, for example, to principal, to SDM officer, to CEO of any company, to editor of any newspaper, and etc. So today we will do only formal letter. So let us start. So before starting, there are some points to remember while writing informal letters or formal letters. While writing informal letters, we should use informal tone. We can use informal tone language, and language should be easy, simple, and clear. Okay, but we should use correct format while writing any letter. And while writing formal letter. Our language should be pleasing tone, and while writing formal letters we should be to the point and straightforward, and be polite and formal. Avoid using any intimate greetings. And while writing letter to editor, don't ask him to solve your problem. He can only publish your views. So let us start. So this is format of formal letter. So first of all, we should start from the top left corner of the page by sender's address. Sender's address is the address of a person who is writing the letter. After that, date, when the letter is written. Write down date should be written in this format. For example, today is 13th May. So 13th May 2020. Letter should be written in this format only. While writing letter, date will not be accepted in this format. This is cross. Okay. After that, recipient's address is come to whom we are sending the letter. By proper name, place, and designation. After that, subject will come. While writing formal letters, this point is very important. We should write subject. We should use formal language only, and it will provide information regarding what the letter is all about. After that, salutation will come. Salutation involves dear, respected. Okay, the words like dear, to whom, if we are writing a letter to any stranger person, the person whom we know, so we can use dear. Or if you are writing a letter to principal, so we should also use the words like respected madam or respected sir. Also, we can only use sir, madam, or ma'am like this. But you should never use word like this. Ma'am, this is correct. Incorrect. Okay. So after that, body of letter will come, and it will start from the leftmost corner itself. So letter should be written in 3-4 paragraphs. If you want, then maybe 5 paragraphs. But I think this is enough. 3-4 paragraphs. After that, thanking you or thank you, and after that, complimentary clause will come. For example, yours obediently, yours sincerely, yours faithfully, yours truly. There are many examples. While we are writing letter to principal, we can often use yours obediently. While we are writing to editor, we can use yours sincerely or yours truly. So there are different words for different persons. After that, sender's name. The person who is sending letter, write name of that person. And if designation is given of that person, then you should also write her or him or his designation. So this is the basic format. Now we will do only body. We will consider the steps included in body. So here we will see how to frame the body of a letter. A letter should be written in 3-4 paragraphs always, okay, which contain all information, your views, thoughts about the problem. Next, first of all, in first paragraph, you have to mention introduction, in which you have to introduce yourself, who you are, and what is the problem. Should be in brief, few words, okay, in one or two lines. Then after that, you should mention main content. Main content includes causes and effect of problem. Causes and effect, what is the cause of problem and what are effects of problem. After that, conclusion. Conclusion includes suggestions for solving problem. If you know any suggestion of problem or for solving that problem, you can also mention your suggestions for solving a problem. Okay, then after that you mention thanking you or thank you, or also this beautiful clause which says please do needful and oblige. This is very beautiful clause. If you mention this one, you will get good marks, even grace marks. So there is one shortcut to frame a body of letter PCES. P represents problem, C represents cause, E represents effect, and S represents solution. So if you learn these four words PCES, problem, first of all you have to mention the problem by introducing yourself. After that you have to mention cause, and after that you have to mention effects of that problem, and at last you have to mention the solutions for that problem. If you are writing letter to editor, then you also mention, I hope you will publish my views in your newspaper. Now we will do an example for a letter to editor. You will understand more clearly. So this is example. Suppose you are any person from Shiva Colony, Pune, and you have to write a letter to editor of the Tribune for increasing number of road accidents. So let us start. First of all, you have to mention your house number, area, and then city. After that, this is your matlab, this means sender's address. After that, you will mention your date in this format. After that, you have to mention recipient's address, that is editor. So the editor, newspaper's name, the Tribune, and city of that newspaper, Pune. After that, you will use subject. Subject includes formal information of what the letter is all about. So we have written here is increasing number of road accidents. So here we are using salutation, dear sir, because we are stranger to that editor, so therefore we use dear sir. So this line, through the column of your esteemed newspaper, I would like to express my views over. This line from here to here, this line should be same in every letter to editor. Through the column of your esteemed newspaper, I would like to express my views over the topic, the problem, the increasing number of accidents. So this is introduction, first paragraph. In second paragraph, you have to start with the problem. Problem, we have noticed that number of road accidents is increasing rapidly. This is problem. So many people either lose their precious lives or getting seriously injured. Again, this is problem. After that, actually there is too much traffic on roads. Now this is cause. Why is this problem occurring? Actually there is too much traffic on roads these days. The number of vehicles has increased dramatically. People don't follow traffic rules and drive at very fast speed. So all these are causes. Again, two-wheelers don't wear helmets and therefore sustain serious head injuries when they meet an accident, or they can even die. So this line is effect. What the problem is causing. Okay. Now we will do ahead. So problem, causes and effect we have done. Now this is solution to the problem. There is an urgent need to check these fatal accidents. We have expressed our view. Now we should mention our views, our solutions to the problem. People should be forced to drive within the limited speed, wearing seat belts and helmets. This is solution to the problem. Now, those who drive after drinking should be punished. Okay, again this is solution. Only then we can save people from being killed in a road accident. This whole paragraph includes the solution to problem. And after that, this is a line to write when you are writing letter to editor. that I hope you will publish my views in your newspaper. Please do needful and oblige. This is a clause. I have already told you that you can use this phrase or this clause in place of thanking you or thank you. It means the same. After that, you will write yours sincerely. Letter Y and S should be capital. Okay. Now, the name of resident of Colony Shiva. So, this is the example. I hope you understand. So, thank you students for joining the class. Please do like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you.